What's up, everybody? I've been using Raspberry Pis for various projects for years. Ever since the release of the Raspberry Pi 3, I've wanted just a little bit more. A little bit more power, a little bit more speed, and a few more options. Now that the Raspberry Pi Foundation has released the new Raspberry Pi 3 Model B+, I wanted to dive into the specifics and do a side-by-side comparison of the B against the B+. Stay tuned. Let's start with the basics. The new Raspberry Pi 3 B+ comes with a quad-core 64-bit processor at 1.4 GHz. That's a 10% increase from the older Model B, which already had a solid 1.2 GHz quad-core processor. The new B+ model also has 1 GB of RAM, four USB 2.0 ports, a stereo output jack, a full-sized HDMI port, CSI and DSI ports for cameras and displays, a 40-pin GPIO header block, and a beefy 2.5 amp power source limit. But what are the biggest differences? The new Pi 3 B+ comes with dual band Wi-Fi at 2.4 and 5 GHz, including 802.11b, G, N, as well as AC, in addition to Bluetooth 4.2 BLE. It also comes with gigabit Ethernet on the USB 2.0 bus, allowing for transfer speeds of up to 300 megabits per second. Lastly, my favorite feature, power over Ethernet. Using an optional hat that sits on the GPIO header port, you get a full-blown power supply with a power output of 5 volts at 2.5 amps to drive your Pi as well as its accessories. This will finally allow the Raspberry Pi to be used as a fully standalone solution in industrial-grade systems. So what do we do now? Let's compare the units side by side. On the left, we have the new Model B+. On the right, we have the original Pi 3 Model B. There are some noticeable differences on the board layout itself. The B+ has fewer visible components, the overall layout is much cleaner, and as a whole, it feels a lot less delicate. I'm using Samsung Evo 32GB SD cards for testing on both Raspberry Pi units. I'm using Noob's 2.7 for both units as well. After inserting the SD cards, I plugged in the two power cords. The power was supplied by a Rigel lab-grade bench power supply so I could accurately measure the power drawn by each unit, as well as turn them on simultaneously for boot time testing. I also plugged in two computer monitors. I first booted them one by one to install Raspbian using the Noob's 2.7 installer. The old Raspberry Pi Model B took about 23 minutes, with the new Raspberry Pi Model B Plus taking a bit more than 10 minutes to install Raspbian. With everything installed, I flipped on the power to both Raspberry Pi units at the same time to see which booted faster. Overall, the boot times are roughly the same, plus or minus a second or two. Sometimes the new model boots minimally faster, sometimes the old model does. Generally, performance appears to be similar. Maybe a bit faster on the B+ in overall performance, but nothing too significant when used as a general desktop computer with Raspbian. Watching YouTube is poor on both units. LibreOffice Writer works well in both, and Minecraft definitely runs better on the newer unit over the older one. As a command line only system, you would probably be able to notice the extra 10% processor power just a little bit more, but with a full GUI, it's negligible. The biggest difference between the two units that I found was in SD card write times. The older Model B averages about 5.8 megabytes per second, whereas the B+ averages 16.8 megabytes per second in write times. That's nearly 3 times the write performance on the same SD card from one unit to the next. Read times for the Model B average out at around 21 megabytes per second for both models, leaving read times at what's essentially a tie. You can also see the B+ outperforms in the 4K read-write scenarios as displayed on the screen. So what does this mean for you as the end user? Well, it really depends. If you're the average person who's using a Raspberry Pi for a home project, probably not all that much. If you've got a dozen of these things spread around your home or office, all connected by Wi-Fi and powered by USB, it might be worth looking at the upgrade to the Pi B+ if you need better Wi-Fi performance, or you want to move to power over Ethernet for combined network and power for simplicity's sake. In the end, if you're the average home user and use it as a desktop, you might not see the immediate benefits over the Raspberry Pi Model B that you currently have in place. If you're a hardware developer that focuses on rapid prototyping or embedded projects, no question, go with the B+. It's a lot more efficient with power consumption, offers a wider range of connectivity options, and has much better write times. Whichever you choose, they're both fantastic products that will surely do you well in whatever embedded projects you happen to be working on. Coming up, we'll be reviewing two other products associated with the Raspberry Pi product line, the 7-inch touchscreen display and the Element 14 Pi desktop enclosure. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up. Like the channel as a whole, subscribe and click that bell icon to receive notifications whenever we upload a new video. If you have any questions about this video or have any suggestions for future projects, please write to us. We love conversation and discussion, especially about science, technology, and the arts. Until next time, see ya.